What's up, traders? If you have read my website, you will know that I'm a huge fan of trend following. So in this video, I'm going to share one of my favorite trend following systems. It uses the triple exponential moving average and a QQE. Let's get started. Every indicator tries to strike a balance between smoothness and responsiveness. Let's take the normal exponential moving average, for example. With a short lookback period like 5 bars, the moving average becomes very responsive, but very choppy. With a long lookback period, you get the opposite, smooth but slow to respond. Can we get the best of both worlds? This is what the triple EMA tries to achieve in the following manner. First, take an EMA of prices, as per usual. Let's call that EMA 1. Then you take an EMA of EMA 1, giving you EMA 2. You repeat that again, giving you EMA 3. The triple EMA is then calculated with this formula. Therefore, by repeatedly smoothing prices and adding them in different proportions, the triple EMA removes a large amount of lag. Here's a comparison of the 40-period triple EMA with the normal EMA. You can see that the triple EMA reacts much faster, which makes it valuable when trying to quickly capture emerging trends. The QQE is derived from the popular RSI and is a bit of a mystery indicator. It's not available in MT4 by default, but you can download it from the MQL5 marketplace. I have included the download link in the description. With a 14-bar lookback period, here is how the QQE stacks up against the regular RSI. Unlike the RSI, the QQE consists of two lines, the smoothed RSI line and the slow trailing line. If we open up the source code for the QQE, you can see its calculation, but it's not the most user-friendly, so let me break it down for you. First, calculate the 14-period RSI. Obtain the smoothed RSI line by taking the 5-period EMA of the RSI. Then obtain the absolute value of the bar-to-bar changes in the smoothed RSI. Then apply a 27-period EMA twice to the values in step 3. Finally, obtain the slow trailing line by multiplying the result of step 4 by 4.236. The QQE is thus essentially a heavily smoothed RSI. The idea is to jump on board a long-term trend during a pullback. I'll use the triple EMA to help me trade in the direction of the longer-term trend. I'll use the following rules for longs. The close is above the 20-period triple EMA, which is in turn above the 40-period triple EMA. The 40-period triple EMA must be rising. The QQE will be used to detect the resumption of the main trend after a pullback. So I will go long when the smoothed RSI line crosses above the slow trailing line. This indicates bullish short-term momentum. Finally, I will avoid entering the market on Monday, since that is usually the day with the lowest volatility. If the entry conditions are met, I'll place a buy stop at the previous high, which will be valid for 3 bars. For exits, I'll use a 120 pip stop loss and trailing stop. I found this simple combination to work well for trend following. Rules are symmetrical on the short side. This is an example of a successful short trade. The close is below both moving averages, showing momentum is to the downside, and we have the QQE's smoothed RSI line crossing below the slow trailing line. The trailing stop did a great job at protecting my open profits without limiting them, and the trade was eventually closed with about 800 pips of profit. Since we're going to be using a pair of triple EMAs, let's first add variables for the lookback periods. The fast period is set to 20, and the slow period is set to 40. Next up is the variable for the stop loss and trailing stop. I'm using 120 pips for both, so only one variable is required. Now for the entry conditions. First up is the close above the 20-period triple EMA. So search for TEMA. There it is. It uses close prices by default, and let's change the period to the variable we just made. Repeat that for the condition where the 20 period triple EMA is above the 40 period one. For the 40 period triple EMA rising condition, we can use the time shift. So the EMA with the shift of 1, which refers to the most recently completed bar, is above the EMA at the shift of 2, which is the bar before that. For the QQE crossover, the condition is pre-programmed, so just search for QQE and select value 1 crossing above value 2, which is the smoothed RSI crossing above the slow trailing line. Lastly, we have the Monday filter, so make sure the current day of the week is not 1. For the action, let's use enter at stop. Price will be the previous high. Use global money management, which we can later adjust here at the top right. The order will be valid for 3 bars. Once a stop order has been placed, I don't want its value to be affected by market conditions, so I will uncheck Replace Existing Order. For the exits, toggle Stop Loss and Trailing Stop and assign the variable earlier. That's it, now let's backtest. This is the 11-year backtest from January 2011. The strategy had a rough start, but has otherwise performed fairly consistently over the years. I decided to remove the QQE entry condition and redo the backtest. And wow, what a difference it makes. I generally find that using moving averages in isolation will lead to disappointing results, regardless of your type of moving average. If this video brought value to you, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Check out the link in the description for your discount off the AlgoWizard Pro plan. Till next time, trade well, and may the pips be with you.